Do you have a hard time feeling worthy and deserving of love? Do you want to feel that worthiness so that you can actually attract the love that you want or feel worthy in your current relationship? If you do, then definitely watch this video. Hi, it's Katia Morozova, dating and relationship coach for men who are ready to attract an amazing woman into their life and have a meaningful connection. I'm also the founder of KatiaMorozova.me. If you're new to my channel and you want notifications every week when I post a new video showing you how to be a secure man and attract an amazing woman, then definitely hit the subscribe button. Many of the people that I work with come to me with some variation of this challenge. They come to me because they believe that they're somehow not good enough of the relationship that they truly want. They don't feel worthy, or they feel like they're unlovable. Worthiness is a huge determinant of the kind of person that you end up with. But not only that, it also is the determinant of how much love, how much enjoyment and fulfillment you're going to be able to feel in a relationship. If you're feeling like you're unworthy or that you're not enough, it will be difficult for you to exist in a relationship, to truly enjoy yourself, to relax, to feel like you are loved, to feel like you are special, and that you have something to contribute to a relationship, and that that contribution is acknowledged and seen. First, I want to break down a common misconception around worthiness. This will be a game changer for you if you can understand this small shift in how you perceive your worthiness. People come to me and they say, Katia, I want to feel worthy. I want to feel like I'm enough, or I want to feel lovable. Here's the problem with this statement. Worthiness is not a feeling. It is not an emotion. Lovable and good enough is not an emotion. All of these things are thoughts. This is why you can never actually feel worthy. So I often find when people are striving towards worthiness, it's like this mysterious destination that we never actually arrive at. So let me assert something here. I think what you're really wanting is you're wanting to feel good. You're wanting to feel good about yourself, and you're striving for some kind of emotion. I want to ask you a question. How will you feel once you feel worthy? What is the way that you will feel if you actually had the experience of worthiness? If worthiness is a thought and not an emotion, then I assert that underneath that is an emotion that you're searching for. So I want you to consider, if you weren't feeling this unworthiness, if you weren't feeling this drab experience of your worth and your value, how would you feel instead? What emotions would be there that aren't there right now? Worthiness just doesn't appear when you want it to, if you haven't noticed. But the truth is that you already are worthy. You have never not been worthy. There's just some belief system that got wired up that made you equate one thing with another. Worthiness with something else. Usually this belief system came from childhood, and it's something that has gone unchecked for a period of time. But there are probably plenty of areas in your life where you do feel worthy because you don't question your own worthiness in those areas. Any area of your life where you don't question your worthiness, you already feel that sense of enoughness. So start to look for areas where you already do feel like you're enough. Can you give me one area where you already feel worthy? I was watching this video on worthiness by Abraham Hicks, and she asked this question. She said, who bestows worthiness? It's almost as if your worthiness is defined by someone else. And I want you to consider that. I thought that was such a great question. Who are you allowing your worthiness to be measured by? Are you allowing your worthiness to be measured by your partner? Are you allowing your worthiness to be measured by your lack of having a partner? Is it that your worthiness is defined by your community or your family? Or was it defined long ago by your parents? I want you to ask yourself, who bestows your worthiness? And then I want you to consider that maybe it's time to rebuild a new relationship with the owner of your worthiness. What if you took your worthiness back into your own hands? If you let other people or other things define your worthiness, define who you are, you're always going to be playing a losing game. So if you're ready to take your worthiness back, ask yourself the question, who bestows my worthiness? And who would you like to be the owner of your worthiness? What if you could be the one who defines your worthiness? The final tip I want to share with you is an unconventional one. And most types of self-development will say, you're not a victim, you're not unworthy, you're not broken. But the reality is that if you feel those things, if you have the experience of being unworthy, then that is your experience. And if someone tells you to not feel that way, it doesn't necessarily mean that you can just stop. So what if you could actually accept this experience that you're having? One of the most liberating experiences that I ever had, I felt broken all of the time and I didn't know how to change it. And that's something that colored my life for a very, very long time. And I worked with coaches and I worked with people who would tell me that I wasn't broken or that there was nothing wrong with me. But it didn't matter because that is how I felt. I felt broken. One of the most powerful things that a guide said to me was, what if it's okay to feel broken? That changed everything for me. That actually started to help me heal my feeling of brokenness. So I want to leave you with this. What if it's okay for you to feel unworthy? What if that experience that you're having internally is okay and there's nothing to do and nothing to change about? I'm letting you know that if you're feeling unworthy, if you're thinking that you are unworthy, maybe it's okay to just feel that and to be with that experience and to not need to change it. See what happens if you just allowed it to be there instead of pushing against it so hard. One of the key components of my work with my clients is helping them normalize their experience, whatever it is. I find that a lot of self-development work and a lot of coaching is framed around the idea that you need to somehow transform negative feelings, negative thoughts, negative beliefs about yourself and change them into something positive. But to me, that feels like a fix-it solution. And it's not always a permanent one. Yes, maybe you can shift into a positive state for a moment, but if those deep-rooted beliefs are still there in your system, in your psychology, in your nervous system, in your body, then that's not going to shift things for you long-term. So much of our culture says it's not okay to feel certain things. So much of our culture says that we need to be positive and focus on good things all the time, when often that is not the case and not how we feel. So instead of running away from feelings that don't feel good, I work with people to help them normalize their experience, normalize the negative emotions that they feel, gain comfort with those emotions, gain comfort with the judgments that they have on their internal experience. When we are constantly striving for a positive experience and trying to get away from a negative experience, it's a losing battle. It's like running a hamster race on a hamster wheel. The only way through is by being comfortable with all the aspects of your internal experience. The good, the bad, the icky, the overwhelming. And there's not many teachers out there who actually teach you how to be with all of you. If you found this video helpful, but you know that you want and need some more customized support so that you can feel worthy and lovable and attract the love that you want, then definitely sign up for a session with me in the description below. Did you like this video? If you did, definitely hit the thumbs up. And if you haven't yet subscribed to my channel and you want to get notifications of when I post a new video every week showing you how to be secure in your skin and attract an amazing partner, then definitely hit the subscribe button. Watch these videos next if you want to learn how to be secure in your skin and attract an amazing partner.